Welcome to Module 6 of the online Chapter Secretary Training, calling this District and Society Relationships. And you go, what the heck is this relationship? It's a miscellaneous reporting of financial matters, reporting the officer elections, registering for training, entering a contest, ordering things from Harmony Marketplace, and the House of Delegates meetings at your district. Now let's look at the details.
This is module number 6 of the Chapter Secretary Training. We're going to discuss the district and society relationships. Specifically within your role as a Chapter Secretary, you serve as a bridge of information between not only the members of your chapter, but also the other officers, the other chapters in your area, your district, and the society. We're also going to discuss the responsibility for reporting, specifically around filings and officers. We're also going to discuss registering for trainings and contests, as well as ordering from the Harmony Marketplace. Let's get started. Reporting filings. The Society requires specific filings be completed and reported in order to maintain your charter status. Chapter secretaries are responsible for reporting this information to the Society and the district. The chapter profile must be updated in eBiz, usually annually. Annual financial reviews are not specifically audits. If you have further questions about your financial review or how to report it, you should speak with your chapter treasurer or contact the Barbershop Harmony Society's manager of chapter leadership and education for more information. You should also let us know when you've completed your IRS 990 or the Canadian equivalent. For your United States chapters, ask your chapter treasurer for a copy of the IRS 990 postcard when it's completed. You can upload it to your profile once it's filed. For Canadian chapters, ask your chapter treasurer if your province or the Canadian Revenue Agency requires an annual filing from your chapter. Even if it's not required, eBiz profile should still be updated. This way you're in compliance with the society. Incorporations. All chapters, regardless if you're from the United States or Canada, must update your eBiz profile, noting your status with your state or province. I'm going to show you how to do this in a moment. Election of officers. Chapter elections must be held by October 15th. Chapter elections are held and coincide with your annual meeting. This is a requirement for a continued existence as a not-for-profit incorporation organization. Candidates should be announced 2 weeks prior to the annual membership meeting, and the announcement of candidates and annual membership meeting should be done in writing, usually through email or letters. Elections are to be conducted with secret ballot unless the slate of officers is uncontested. If you have specific questions about how to run a proper election within your chapter, feel free to reach out to your district secretary or the Barbershop Harmony Society. Now, reporting of officers is extremely important as a chapter secretary. You should report your new officers in eBiz no later than December 15th each year. Also, when an officer resigns or is replaced or a vacancy is filled, your eBiz profile should be updated right away. Let me go ahead and show you in eBiz how to exactly update your chapter profile. If you just want to give me a moment, I'm going to pull up eBiz here. Great. As you can see here, we're already logged into eBiz going through the Barbershop Harmony Society's website under the Members Only section. Go to your My Membership tab and click on My Chapter. You will see a listing of all of your chapters available to you or the ones that you're members of. As you can see here, I'm a member of the Providence, Rhode Island chapter. There are a lot of options here that you can see as the chapter secretary. Right now, I'm going to show you how to update your financial filings. As you can see here, there are a few options. I'm going to click on Financial Filings. And you can see that the three items that I mentioned prior are listed here: 990s, the financial review section, and the state incorporation filing. When you're ready to update your 990 filing or your financial review or state incorporation, you should update it based on the year that you're filing for. So in this case, I'll choose 2015, and I'll choose the date that it was filed. So we'll say that it was filed today. If I have the 990 postcard that my treasurer sent me, I can attach that here. And then I'm going to press Add. As you see now, my chapter profile has been updated that it was filed by me and the date that it was filed. I should do this for all of these if they've been accomplished. For a reminder for our Canadian friends, even though you don't have a 990 filing, you should still write the fiscal year and the date filed so that your chapter profile is completely up to date. Same thing goes for your financial review and the state incorporation filing. If you need further clarification on this, please feel free to reach out to your district secretary or the Barbershop Primary Society. Now I'm going to show you how to update your officers. I'm going to go back to my chapter profile, and I'm going to see the section where it says chapter leaders. As you can see here, there's a current listing of all of the chapter leaders within my personal chapter. As you can see here, I'm listed as the assistant director. Let's say I'm no longer serving as the assistant chorus director. I can actually press edit. And instead of a delete option, I'm just going to change the date to when it was effective. So in this case, we'll say that I'm no longer the assistant director as of yesterday. I press update. And as you see here, I'm no longer listed. Well, let's say they recruited a new assistant director whose name happens to also be Antonio Lombardi. I'm going to choose the role. The start date is when they started. Let's say they started today. And we'll say the end date is at least till the end of the year. I'm going to press add leader. And now you can see my current list is already up to date. If I want to go back and look at past leaders, I can also do that. And if I want to add in future leaders, I can also do that. If you have a female director or someone who is an associate, you can also add them here. You need to know their Barbershop Harmony Society ID number. And then you can choose the role. There's specific roles here, as you can see, chorus director, assistant chorus director, chapter counselor, etc. And you, just like before, you enter the start date and the end date. Let's go back to my presentation here. Just give me 1 second. Thanks for your patience, folks. Registering for trainings and contests. Each district has their own policies regarding registering for trainings, schools, and events. If you're looking to attend a district event, you should reach out to your district secretary and ask them how exactly they expect for you to register for a event such as a school or any trainings that they have available, such as Leadership Academy. Most commonly, the chapter secretary is responsible for submitting registrations on behalf of the chapter. But again, each district has their own set of policies and procedures. For registering for a contest, it's done through what's called the CJ20 process. You should check with your chapter on their common practices on who exactly files the CJ20. Most often it's the chapter secretary, but sometimes it's also the VP of Music and Performance. A CJ20 is submitted online through eBiz under the Contest Entry tab. There's a deadline for submission, and it varies from district to district. Usually the district website has the most up-to-date information. Direct questions, comments, or concerns about filing a CJ20 should be directed to your district vice president of contests and judging, or sometimes they refer to it as a DRCJ. The type of information that you need to file the CJ20 is pretty simple. You need the names of the directors. By the way, if they're a female, they must be an associate in order to compete. You also need to know the songs that you're going to be singing at contest. Certification is required to confirm that the arrangements are legal according to copyright law. You'll need the song titles, the composers, the arrangers, and proof that the songs were legally purchased and the arrangers were paid for with their services. You can enter more songs than required if you're unsure what your chorus plans to sing. You should re-enter the information in eBiz as soon as you know what songs you're going to sing definitely or if your plans change. Another responsibility of the chapter secretary is to vouch for and to ensure that all of your members who are competing are actual members of the society. It is vital that the chapter secretary is able to determine and certify that each member of his competing chorus is paid up. This is especially critical when a member's renewal comes due immediately prior to the spring, fall, or international contest. Penalties for having non-members or non-paid up members singing at a contest may be severe, including disqualification. Let's talk about ordering from the Harmony Marketplace. There are a lot of resources and supplies available to you through the Barbershop Harmony Society's Harmony Marketplace. You can visit it online at www.shop.barbershop.org. You should speak with your chapter leadership on common practices specific to your chapter, on who exactly is responsible for ordering resources and supplies. For most chapters, it is the chapter secretary or the chapter treasurer. The process is pretty simple. Chapters must pay online or over the phone using a credit card or debit card. You can either use the chapter's credit card or arrange for reimbursement within your group, whatever is most comfortable for you and the chapter. Chapters do not have the option to be invoiced by the society. This is a change from prior years. It is important for your chapter to have a policy about other members ordering merchandise on behalf of the chapter. For further comments, questions, or concerns, please feel free to reach out to your district secretary or the Barbershop Harmony Society's customer service department. You can also check out the Barbershop Harmony Society's website for the most up-to-date information. Thanks so much, and we'll see you at the next module.